A group of scientists is urging the Biden administration to update the CDC guidelines on COVID-19. Two of the scholars from UC San Diego say the agency needs to recognize that aerosol particles are the primary source of transmission. They tell ABC 10 News reporter Rena Nakano the government needs to catch up to the science.
We wrote this letter to put inhalation front and center.
In a letter to the Biden administration, these scientists say the government must immediately update COVID-19 regulations for people in the workplace. It all starts with acknowledging that the spread of COVID is happening at the microscopic level. Currently, the CDC's website shows that COVID-19 spreads most commonly during close contact through larger respiratory droplets. If you scroll down, it says it can sometimes be spread by airborne transmission. These scientists say it's much more prevalent than that.
Inhaling these small particles is a major way that people are infected.
They're asking the administration to mirror Germany, Australia, and France's new policies that mandate the use of N95 masks to all healthcare workers, not just those in the COVID unit, as well as high-risk workers in confined spaces, such as bus drivers and food processing workers.
Workers are not being offered the kind of protection they need.
They're also urging the government to update OSHA workplace standards on ventilators, respirators, and masks, then use the Defense Production Act to organize a national production and distribution network, and for the public to create a clear face covering standard.
Filterability, wearability, and fit, that the public will be able to judge the quality of the mask they're buying.
UCSD professor Kim Prather says the government needs to act now.
Why aren't you using this? Their answer is we are following the CDC guidelines and they are not adequate right now. And so that's not okay. If we really want to end this pandemic, we have to acknowledge that this virus is spreading through the air, or we are just gonna keep yo-yoing back and forth.
Rena Nakano, ABC 10 News.
When asked about double masking, these scientists said it's most important to find one well-fitted mask that has low breathing resistance and high filtration efficiency.